I was sitting in a bar room one rainy afternoon, telling stories about rodeo and listening to a tune. The rodeo starts tomorrow in this one-horse town, so Bill took our names and put our entries down. I went to the office the next day to see what bareback horse I had to pay my fees. I looked on the list, but my name wasn't found. I thought Bill might have forgot to put me down. I looked on the board and I happened to find my name was on another list. I was in the bull riding. My knees began to knock and my face began to sweat, and I heaved and gagged on the rodeo office steps. Well, I may be a fool, but a coward I'm not, so I borrowed a bull rope with a bell in the knot. I walked into the arena with them other bull riding fools and walked down the chutes and found my bull. Then I put my rope in the middle of his back and had some cowboy pull out the slack, and then I wrapped the tail around my hand and back and said, "Boys, open the gate just a little bitty crack." Well, a bull hit the gate with his head, and I could see over his hump that his eyes was red. He bailed out of there with a big snort and a beller, and something inside me told me I was yeller. Well, the dust and hair and flies from off his hump, it whisked to my nose as he made another jump, and the stink of it all was more than I could stand, so I jerked my wrap and opened my hand. Well, he jumped in the air and he made one more turn, and as the rope slid through my hand, it showed it burned. He flanged me down in a great big heap, then right in the middle of me, he did leap. With his feet on my belly, standing in place, that dirty old bull blew snot in my face. So them damned old bulls, you can run them in a chute and put your ropes on them big galoots, but the closest you're gonna find me to their stinking hair is to help some other fool get flung in the air. Boy, next time I see Bill, I'm gonna break his dang neck. Enter me in the bull riding with it. Well, shoot, I think I'll enter him in the barrel racing or something.